Today we'll be talking about motor duty cycles. This refers to the sequence and duration and time of all aspects of a typical motor operation. These can include starting, electric braking, no load, load, or rest. What are motor duty cycles? It's important to remember that duty cycles are temperature driven. So when selecting a motor, a customer should make sure to declare to the motor manufacturer what the duty cycle is. With this information, the motor manufacturer can determine if the selected motor is sufficient, if additional cooling such as forced ventilation is required, or if a wholly new motor should be used for the operation. The International Electrotechnical Commission, or IEC, declared 8 different duty cycles that are grouped by continuous, short-term, or periodic duty. The first motor duty cycle we'll talk about is continuous duty, also referred to as S1 duty. In this type of operation, a constant load is applied throughout the operation, and then the temperature goes from ambient and is allowed to reach a constant temperature at the motor's thermal equilibrium. This is the simplest type of motor duty cycle. The next one we'll talk about is short-term duty. The short-term duty cycle is very similar to the continuous duty cycle in that a constant load is applied to the motor. Unlike the continuous duty, the load is removed before the motor is allowed to reach its thermal equilibrium. At this point, the motor rests and it's allowed to cool down until it reaches the ambient temperature of the environment. The short-term duty cycle is abbreviated as S2, followed by the number of minutes in the cycle. Next, we'll talk about the periodic duty cycle. Periodic duty refers to the abbreviations S3 through S8. This graph shows S3, or intermittent periodic duty. This type of duty cycle has identical cycles of a constant load followed by a period of rest repeated over time. It's similar to short-term duty, where the constant load is applied, and then when it's at rest, the motor is allowed to cool down. Unlike short-term duty, it's never allowed to reach the ambient temperature of the environment, but then the load is reapplied, so the temperature spikes back up. Intermittent periodic duty is referred to as S3 followed by a percentage. The percentage refers to the amount of time under load divided by the total amount of time of the cycle. So in this graph, it would be roughly 50% duty. The next, more complex type of motor duty cycle we'll talk about is continuous operation with electric braking, or S7 duty. In this type of operation, there's electric braking, starting, constant load applied to the motor, and then electric braking, starting, constant load, and it repeats on and on. During this type of operation, the motor does not get any rest periods. The temperature increases the most during the electric braking and starting portion, and it's allowed to somewhat cool down when the constant load is applied to the motor. The other periodic duty cycles are similar to S3 and S7 duty cycles, where they're just sequences of operations repeated over and over in a cycle. These other periodic duty cycles can be with or without starting, loading, resting, or electric braking. When selecting a motor, it's very important to notify the motor manufacturer of your motor duty cycle. This ensures that the motor is properly selected for your application. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Check us out on our other social media channels, or check us out at kebamerica.com.